Hey guys, SB Architects here. Today I'm going to show you how to create realistic water material in Twinmotion, but in pet tracing, because when we are using pet tracing, actually I didn't use Twinmotion for villa renders. I have been using T5 or V-Ray, but I found a workaround for this issue. It's gonna be a very short tutorial, so let's get started. Alright guys, here we are in Twinmotion again, and at the very first, the most important thing is it's not working in SketchUp importing. In the SketchUp, we have to use export data submit to Twinmotion. I don't know why, but it didn't work when I directly imported the SketchUp file. So here the first model I have tried. And this is the second model I've tried. For summary, who doesn't know for this problem? Well, when you assign water material in Twinmotion, let's go to water material and go to water and pool. It's working very well, but when we use pet tracing, it looks like this. It's very ugly and we cannot change its settings. As you can see here, I'm changing the water depth or any kind of something like this, color and etc. It's not working. I cannot see the depth of the water. So this is our problem. Instead of that, we are going to use a workaround. We go to material again, and this time we are going to use glass material. Actually, glass have same refraction value as water, so we can use the glass material for our pool. But when we are using pool, it's very straight, so we need to use some bump to simulate a pool material. But we don't have any bump here, so we are going to use other glass material, which is this Contoura pattern glass. Actually, I have tried other patterns, but they are not looking as water bump. So very close one is this one, Contoura pattern glass. And after we assign that, we will get something like this, but we are going to change the settings. First, we are going to change the bump and scale, of course, and it's nearly done. And maybe you can change the opacity. It's up to mood of your scene. As you can see, our pool is ready. Pros of doing that is it's very realistic, I think. It's realistic, but minus is it's not animating. It's still model, so you need to be very careful when you are taking animations if your camera close enough to pull. By the way, you can change the bump material, of course. For instance, let's go to more here and click this icon and click open. And I have found water bump material for this tutorial. Let's use that. And go back to the scale one. And change the bump. It's this material. It's seamless, so that means you won't see any lines from borders. And this material simulates water better than before, I think. Before Contoura pattern glass. You can find this very easily. You can just go to the Google and search water bump seamless and you will find it. By the way, if you use same material with the SketchUp model, let's try that. Let's drag and drop here and open pet tracing. You will see something like this. I don't know why, but it looks always white and doesn't show your texture. Let's change the bump and scale. Maybe 20 here. And it's not useful. This is SketchUp model. This is DataSmith model. But of course, exported from SketchUp file. Let's go back to scale 1 or 10, maybe 5, 3. Okay, there we go. That was all it for this tutorial. If you liked it, please hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe. By the way, you can support the channel by becoming my Patreon from the Patreon page. You can support me there. And with that, you can also find more ArchiCAD tutorials and libraries. Alright guys, thank you for watching again and have a nice day.